this tanker.
I'm right behind it.
What's happening? Welcome back to another episode of Freedom Pro. I want to thank you guys for stopping in. If you guys don't know, my name's Adam. And we love exploring the outdoors. This week, we are in Green Lake, Wisconsin on the Big Green. If you're not aware of this lake, this is the deepest lake in Wisconsin. It pushes, I think, close to 300 foot. And because of that, it's mid-June here. And these bass are behind. You can still catch them pre-spawn, you can catch them on beds, and you can catch them post-spawn. So we're going to try and chase some big largemouth, big smallmouth down, see what we can find. You know, this is a very productive lake, great fishery, and maybe even tear into some walleyes and crappies. We usually do that while we're out here, but we're excited to bring you guys along, like always. And if you guys are new here and you like exploring the outdoors, especially your Freedom Outdoors and all that, I mean, everything that comes along with that, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Without further ado, let's get to getting.
Found one on a bed here, kind of cutting along the bluff base. It gets real sandy to like a rocky transition. So if you see one sitting on a bed right here, we're going to try and make that happen. Dude, didn't even get on the bed. Look at that. Beautiful brown fish. Didn't even get. I bet you it's 4 foot deep here. Right when that thing hit the water, this fish just came right for it. Right for it. Look at this tanker. Look at that. That's a beautiful fish. Big green lake smallmouth. Just chunky. Man, you guys gotta come check out Green Lake. They got some quality fish.
This godforsaken rock bass. Same one I caught before.
Oh, you might be going live well until I can get this G-dang smallie to bite, buddy. I see the hole in your lip from the last bait you took of mine. Oh. thing's got to be 18 plus inches. Great fish. Great looking fish. Little smallmouth, hammered that megabass jerkbait. Nice little guy right there. Just casting to this transition where these beds are. It's getting hard to see them right now. And figuring not only are there beds there, but they might be pulling off the beds, whatever, just throwing a jerkbait. This water's a little dirty, but even if it was clear, I'd probably still be throwing this color. It's a very loud, flashy color. Chartreuse, gold, blue. It's got some purple, pink in there. It just seems like it's a bait that they trigger on after, you know, you get that standard jerkbait bite and you get to these warmer months. Key when you're fishing a jerk bait in some clear water is definitely watching behind your bait. You know, even as it gets 30 yards out, you can start seeing if those fish are behind it and how they're reacting to it. Plus, it tells you if you're doing the right thing, right? That last fish I just caught over there, I had, it looked like a nice 2.5 pounder followed up to the boat. So I knew they were right there, and I just kept being persistent pounding that spot. Eventually one bit, so that's part of fishing, right? You just gotta stay persistent, but also keying in on those little intricacies. What the fish are doing, are they following up? Typically, if I see a lot of followers on a jerkbait, I just get more aggressive because I give them less time to look at it. So maybe that's something to try if you're getting a lot of follows on a jerkbait. Just start ripping it real hard. It keeps it in the strike zone less, but they have less time to look at it, and typically you'll get that reaction bite. Got all the hooks on that one. That fish, I saw him come up behind it, pause. He liked it on the pause, give it a quick little twitch, and now he's in the boat. I mean, just a solid, you know, 1.5 pound fish, but just keying in on those little nuances. Another good tactic out here is just a simple tube jig, trying to mimic crawfish, finding these offshore rocks. Plenty out here, on your graph, you can find them, but that's just a good tactic. If the crawfish are on the rocks, you usually can find them. or just cookie cutter? I really love about throwing a Carolina rig in rocks is you can really kind of tell what kind of rock you're going to wear. A lot of it, it's big. It just translates that feeling so much. You just got that weight above your main line. You're on the rocks, but can't find the big ones. Caught me by surprise there, little man. I was looking at my graph. Just can't find the biggins today except on the beds. This leader is gonna have to be a retied.
That's going to do it for another one here on Free to Prowl. I want to thank you guys for stopping in. It was a good day. We couldn't exactly find the big ones except on the beds, and that's a little frustrating. Usually this lake produces, you know, in good numbers of good quality fish. So that's disappointing. Not sure what's up there. That's how fishing goes sometimes. But we got on a few, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you learned some stuff along the way. Some key baits today included a drop shot wacky rig Senko or a Siren Dream Shot from Strike King for the betters, and then a Mega Bass 110 jerk bait. I pair my jerk baits with a braided line to a fluorocarbon leader, and that's on a 6 foot six rod. And then I snapped off the Carolina rig right to end my day, but a Carolina rig as well to imitate a crawfish running over the rocks. So those were the key baits. I always have fun chasing smallmouth, and this place is worth it. So if you got a chance, make sure you get out here. It's a good fishery. I know you guys would enjoy it. So I guess with that said, if you guys like what you're seeing here, please hit the subscribe button. Hit the bell if you want to know when our latest videos hit. Our social medias are in the description below, as well as the website if you're interested in any apparel, hats, stickers, etc. So, as always, we appreciate the support. Don't forget you are free to prowl, and thank a vet for their service. We'll catch you in the next one.